None of this matters if we don't find a way to break the rites of ascension.
The spell is complicated. I'm making progress, but I need more time.
Time is something I can't give you, Sanctum. Makros is growing in power even as we speak.
I know. They are using these spirit tethers to reinforce the lunar gate.
Then I must break them.
There should be three of them. I'll guide you. Excellent, Orin. You've broken two tethers. It's not over yet. A captain of the Black Tide is waiting for you.
Very well. I can still lift my weapon. They haven't killed me yet.
Yes, Orin. Do stay alive. Our plan won't work if you're dead.
It's you, the weak sibling. Small and sad, just like I expected.
Let's see who is weak.
We are ready to take on Lunara.
Finally.
I have news, Orin, about the rites of ascension.
Ah, good. You figured out how to break the spell.
Exactly. Now, when we reach Makros, we'll know how to stop him.
Well done, Sanctum. All of Apeirion owes you a debt.
This serves the greater good. Your brother must be stopped. You've gathered enough sigils, and you've cleared all the obstacles. Prepare your weapons. Ready your gear. Deal yourself. It's time for you to face Lunara, guardian avatar of the Silver Moon. The armor of justice was preferred by many Valorian leaders. Valorians who value physical strength look to Bulwark for inspiration. ethereum from the water realm. I perceived it. All of it.
You seem different. Tell me what's happening.
The ethereum is affecting me. Nothing fatal.
You're sure about that? Our plan relies on you.
I'm not dead yet, Orin. So nothing to worry about.
So it's true. The ethereum is making you sick.
Never mind that. Orin, we have a problem.
I'm listening.
As you know, Makros has the rights of ascension, just as we do.
Correct. But if he wants to ascend, he needs ethereum, and we've been taking it away.
Exactly. And that's the problem.
How is that a problem? It's working.
We are winning, and Makros knows it, so now he's desperate. He knows that if all the ethereum disappears, he'll never be able to ascend.
And thanks to us, he's running out, fast.
Exactly. So now he's willing to risk everything and start the rites with what he has left.
That means we're running out of time.
We are done with the Water Realm. It's time to move on our remaining targets. Greaves Sunsteel is next, followed by the Gildan Commander. Head to the Central Tower and rise to the Air Realm. There's something else.
More bad news, I'm guessing.
Makros is wrong.
About what?
About his entire plan. He thinks he can become a god, but he can't.
He can, He has the rights of ascension.
Yes, but they are not what he thinks they are. The rites aren't for ascension to godhood. They're for a different kind of ascension. They're for sacrifice.
Blood sacrifice, you mean?
Exactly. If Makros tries to ascend, odds are he'll die, and most likely destroy the world around him. I've studied the rites. It's all there in the text. If Makros tries to ascend, he will die. I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, Auron. I know he's your brother.
When he chose to betray us, he sealed his own fate.
I won't be beaten by a wicked. Fight me!
Tell Macross I'm coming.
Flying earth motes are the only solid ground up here. Let's move carefully, since the Niak kindred do not like intruders.
Tell me who I face next.
Greaves Sunsteel is Macross's personal godsmith. He's our next target. But first, we need to activate a twilight beacon. The closer you get to Macross, the harder his forces will fight you.
They can't stop me.
Is even more of a menace than I thought.
He's his own worst enemy.
How so?
He's wrong about the rites of ascension. They won't turn him into a god after all.
Why not?
It's a sacrifice ritual. He's a dead man. He's playing with fire. We have to stop him before he wreaks more havoc on this world.
Did you tell Xenon about Macross?
Yes. Where's Greaves?
He's at his forge. We'll search for it at the Shrine of the Godsmiths.
Let's go.
Greaves Sunsteel's lair is somewhere below the Shrine of the Godsmiths on the other side of the Azure Enclave. The land is held by local warbands of the Niak kindred. They are hostile and will attack on sight. Head to the Shrine of the Godsmiths and find the entrance to Greaves Sunsteel's forge.
Nyack. These people were our allies once.
Makros corrupts everything he touches.
Most of all himself.
Several Nyack champions lead their warbands here.
Not for long. Let's try it and see. That's all of them. Sanctum.
Yes.
There's no chance Makros will listen to reason, is there?
I'm afraid not, Orin. That's a rare creature. Careful, Orin.
Thank you.
The Shrine of the Godsmiths. So many ancient artifacts were made here.
Xenon would have wanted to see this place.
The gate to his forge in plain sight.
Or maybe he would. Look at the floor.
You're right. The floor is the door. Now that you've found him, let's get the air sigils we need to unlock it. Head back to the Twilight Beacon. Twilight Beacon. Destroy the crystals to close their portals.
We're running out of time. Makros may complete the rites of ascension before we reach him.
If that happens, we all die.
Why?
If he starts the rites this way, if he starts the ritual without enough Ethereum, it's likely he'll set off a chain reaction. It will rip at the fabric of our universe in ways we cannot predict.
What would happen?
No one knows for sure. Nothing like this has ever happened before, but it could destroy the monolith and everything in it. Let's not wait to find out. You must reach him before it's too late. We have located the entrance to Grieve Sunsteel's forge. As with the others, we will need to gather some more elemental sigils.